To most people, the only sighting of roe deer are their white rumps disappearing into the distance. A very secretive animal, by choice an inhabitant of dense woodland, roe have been present in Britain since prehistoric times. In earlier days, they were widely distributed through the ancient forests, but as they were cleared for fuel and agriculture, the roe was gradually banished to the more remote parts of the north of England and the wilderness of Scotland. Where much of the deer's preferred habitat is managed or created by man, damage caused by large numbers of deer to his trees and crops soon results in steps being taken to reduce the numbers to a more acceptable level. In most situations, this involves the humane selective reduction in deer population using suitable rifles and stalking techniques that minimize disturbance and stress to other animals in the area. Despite a number of highly organized attempts in a number of countries, it has proved impossible to estimate deer populations, living as they do, a solitary and largely secluded existence. An educated guess can be determined by forest and crop damage. Also by past culling history and by the general physical condition of the deer. Incidents of parasites, disease and road casualties can also become a major factor in overpopulated areas of deer. As with most mammal species, it is the female that is the key to balanced and healthy populations. Many stalkers in northern areas prefer to leave the doe cull until as late in the season as possible, allowing any unaccounted fawns the best possible chance of survival. Obvious signs of the deer's presence, such as droppings and slot marks, can give the stalker some idea of the area in which deer are residing. Once located, the most effective way of distinguishing between the sexes is from the rear. The doe carries a distinct tuft of long white hair, resembling a tail, which is absent on the buck. From the front, the buck's new growth of velveted antlers clearly distinguish him from the doe. In addition, the buck has a tuft of long hairs at the end of his sheath. When stalking deer on foot, the hunter must become very efficient at reading the indications of deer presence and using his knowledge of seasonal and behavioral patterns if he is to get within humane killing range of his quarry. Attention to air currents over the ground being stalked is of paramount importance because of the roe's highly developed sense of smell. The prime objective must be to achieve a clean, swift kill. The most vulnerable area of the body is the forward part of the chest. A bullet entering here will destroy either the heart or lungs and will result in a speedy and certain death. If the deer is unaware of the hunter's presence, a shot placed correctly will usually result in the animal's death almost on the spot. If the deer is tense and alert because it senses danger, even a fatal heart shot will not stop the deer from making a sudden dashing run on report of the rifle. In this situation, deer can travel 50 meters or more before dropping.